Hi folks, welcome to today's coffee and Habakkuk. Apologies for the sound, I left my microphone down at the church and I can't go outside anyway because it's again too windy. So I'm afraid rather than the glamorous botanic gardens, we're stuck here in my office at home. This is not the most hope-filled verse in the Bible, but it is kind of hopeful in a way because it offers us principle that you see, let me just read it to you. Chapter 2, verse 15 and 16. Woe to him who gives drink to his neighbours, pouring it from the wineskin till they are drunk, so that he can gaze on their naked bodies. You'll be filled with shame instead of glory. Now it's your turn. Drink and let your nakedness be exposed. The cup from the Lord's right hand is coming round to you, and disgrace will cover your glory. I don't know if you've ever been involved with somebody or even had experiences yourself who's experienced date rape, where someone has used drink or drugs and then taken advantage of somebody. It's utterly horrendous. And that's what's being said here. Woe to the debaucher. It's the shameful treatment that the Babylonians inflicted on the people that they conquered. You give drinks to your neighbours. This is not the Babylonians going to say, hey, have a pint on us, free drinks. It's the intention of debasing them and humiliating them. And then they pour it from the wineskin until they are drunk, so he can gaze on their nakedness. The figure of a drunk man is used of the overthrow of a nation, like in Nahum chapter 3 and verse 11. But it is very, very demeaning when that happens. But it says, you will be filled with shame instead of glory. Again, the actions just go around themselves. This will bounce back against them. I remember speaking to a workmate one time. I was working on a farm and he was going, oh, it was a great night last night. What a magic night, eh? And I wasn't a Christian at the time, and I remember we'd been at a dance. And in the morning, his face was all black and blue because he got so drunk, he got into a fight, he got really beat up. But he was so drunk that he thought, oh, it was a great night, it was a wonderful night, it must have been a great night, I was drunk, it was a great night. He just made an absolute fool of himself. Well, that's what this is talking here. Drink and you will be exposed. But it really is, that's what they're saying. You're saying, you drink and you yourself will be naked. You drink and you yourself will be put to shame. The cup from the Lord's right hand is coming to you. Now, you can have, the cup is a very interesting image. We had communion last weekend and, you know, you get the cup of salvation. But you also get, in the Bible, the cup of God's wrath, which is described, Revelation 16, verse 19, the cup filled with the wine of my wrath. And drinking of this cup is what causes the nations to stagger, as Isaiah and Jeremiah both tell us. Now, to be honest, that's the cup that we all deserve, but it's the cup that Christ drank on our behalf. It's the cup that he took. He drank it instead of us. I think it was Rabbi Duncan who said it was damnation, and he drank it to the full, and he drank it lovingly. So, you know, sometimes we may feel that we deserve the cup of God's wrath, but in reality, Christ has drunk it for us if we believe in him and are his people. And, you know, this, it's not a bad thing to believe that those who inflict cruelty and injustice on other people don't get away with it. So, God bless you. See you tomorrow, hopefully with the proper mic, and we continue to look at this amazing passage. Bye.